getting you up to speed now on the breaking news we've been following all morning. Attorney General Eric Holder says five suspects accused in the 9/11 attacks will be brought to New York City to face trial. He says he'll seek the death penalty against Khalid Sheikh Mohammed, the alleged mastermind of that plot, and four of his alleged co-conspirators. Right now, they're being held at the Guantanamo Bay prison camp in Cuba. When asked about safety concerns and the possibility of the suspects not being convicted, Holder said this.
I would not have authorized the bringing of these prosecutions unless I thought that in the outcome, we would ultimately be successful. I will say that I have access to information that has not been publicly released that gives me great confidence that we will be successful.
Holder says the 9/11 suspects will be tried at a courthouse just blocks away from Ground Zero. There are big political and legal implications to bringing these suspects to New York City, though. NBC terrorism analyst Evan Coleman joins us now to talk more about this. Evan, some members of Congress have been against the idea of bringing these men to New York City. I want to just read one quote from Lamar Smith. He said, quote, "The Obama administration's decision to bring the 9/11 conspirators to the U.S. to stand trial could endanger the American people."
Yeah, well, it's the obvious NIMBY argument, not in my backyard. And there is something to this. I think I said earlier there was a case here in New York at the MCC, the Metropolitan Correctional Center, where you had one defendant who was awaiting trial on terrorism charges who attacked a guard who gave him brain damage using some kind of shiv and basically allowed another prisoner to escape and get up on top of the roof of the MCC and running around on the roof of the MCC. So the
but this
fear
could
is,
conceivably happen with any
it could happen
with
anywhere.
Any prisoner with any person accused.
And let's be honest, this is before 9/11.
Yeah.
After 9/11, with the amount of security that is in place right now with terrorism trials in general, never mind right here in the United States, anyone that's been to the federal courthouse in the Southern District knows what the security there is like.
Mm-hmm.
It is stricter, it is more serious than anywhere else in the country. We have the resources here to deal with these people. I really don't think them escaping is going to be an issue. I think the issue is despite all the evidence that's been gathered, despite the cases that have been built, is the issue of enhanced interrogation techniques going to come up in such a way that it will foil the prosecution of these